live from Bank of America Stadium for the Riot Report. You're about to get a little bit of Josh on Josh action. My name's Josh Klein, managing editor of the Riot Report, contributor Josh Vinson. Welcome.
Hey, how you doing, bro?
Pretty good game tonight?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
16-8, Panthers get the win. What impressed you the most?
This defense. Everyone talked about Ezekiel Elliott coming to this game. Everyone talked about Dak Prescott and what that offense can do. And we've seen what they can do over the years. But six sacks on Dak Prescott for a loss of more than 30-plus yards. And everybody asked after the game and said, hey, Thompson, how do you feel about this? You know, do you have a chip on your shoulder, that kind of thing? And Thompson basically said, hey, look, I've been doing this for all my life. You know, I've been playing this game. I know how to play this game. And that was what was most important to me, is just seeing how this defense came. You know, Carolina Panthers have always been an offensive team, right? We always heard about Cam Newton and his weapons. But we got a defensive team on our hands now.
Yeah, absolutely. I think the reality is that when you look at what this defense was able to do, they really held the Cowboys to almost no yards for the entire game. It was only once they were up 16-0, felt like they maybe took the pressure off a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Cowboys were able to drive down, make it 16-8, kind of put your heart in your throat a little bit for a minute there.
Yeah.
But once it actually came down to it, they kicked the ball back, Sac City, kicked the ball back to him again, Addison forced the fumble. So I feel like that defense, when they really had to step up, they absolutely did.
Exactly. And I mean, the only unfortunate thing is, yes, the Carolina Panthers start off with a win this season, but they lost so much with injuries, as you mentioned.
Yep.
Of course, we don't know exactly the extent of those injuries just yet. We'll find out more today, tomorrow. But, you know, so that was the first thing Coach Rivera said when they asked him the question, like, hey, you know, do you have a status on Wilson? He said, hey, I don't have any status, any updates, anything. We'll know tomorrow. You know, he's letting his medical staff take care of that, but that's the unfortunate part. They won, but at what cost?
Yeah, we'll take you behind the curtain a little bit. Ron Rivera constantly says that he doesn't check with the doctors after the game, so he can't give us answers right at the press conference. So
right,
he doesn't want to know, so he can't tell us. So then we all can kind of imagine what's wrong with them. But the reality is, when Greg Olsen goes to the sidelines, he was sitting on the training table. Trainers were patting him on the head, on the shoulders, trying to kind of console him. Comes back out in a boot on his right foot. I mean, it doesn't look good.
Exactly. And I mean, even in the locker room, we all crowded around him, want to maybe get a quote or two, get a question like, hey, how you feeling? What do you know? What's going on? And I mean, he's a very open guy, right? Always, you know, talking.
Even
to
last year after the injury.
Exactly. You know, but this time, no. He just said, hey, guys, please respect it. I don't want to talk. And had his boot on, walked out on crutches. It was very sad because we saw this all again just last year.
Yep. Darrell Williams carted off in the fourth quarter.
Yeah.
You know, it's going to be a lot of second guessing should he have been brought back. Ron Rivera did qualify after the game and said that it was not a re-injury of the same injury.
Okay.
But the reality is when you're carted off, you can't. They tried to have him limp off the field, but he couldn't get to the sidelines.
He couldn't. Yeah, you saw him on the ground right there on the broadcast, and all his teammates were reaching for him like, hey, come up. And he just was like, I can't get up. Medical staff came onto the field, and as you mentioned, he was carted off. It's just another unfortunate injury for the Carolina Panthers.
So it's going to be next man up. Just like last year, Greg Olsen goes down. They've already lost Matt Khalil,
mm-hmm.
Darrell Williams now. Everybody's got to step up. That's why depth is so important in this league. We'll have more coverage tonight, more stuff tomorrow. So check back on theriotreport.com. Follow us on Instagram, Twitter. Kevin's really excited to be filming this segment, so he's going to have some great stuff, some great pictures on for you. And we'll talk to you guys tomorrow.
Have a good night.